to welcome you, and again, welcome and thank you for being here. Of course, I have to take this opportunity to make a few comments regarding Dr. Lenz, as we do go way back. I wrote down really three words about Janet: capable, reliable, and professional. She's a very capable professional, and we should probably ought to open up that term professional to professional. With respect to the capability, her attention to detail is legendary, and I never forgot her quote. She would often refer to herself as, quote, "I'm the self-anointed queen of detail within the career center." And kept me honest for many years, and I don't know what's right in there. So there's no question about her capability. We'll chronicle more of that in just a few minutes. In terms of reliability, the woman is rock solid in terms of reliability. I remember we're the proud parents of two children, adult children, and I'll never forget when our daughter was very little. She watched a cartoon, I watched it with her, called Space Coasters. And the bad guy was a classic bad guy, stovepipe hat, and tie young women to railroad tracks and all of that. And his name was M.T. Promises. The other major point with Janet is all the folks that she has mentored over the years. Many of you are here. If you've been mentored by Janet, would you just stand and they acknowledge? Her professional contributions, again, you're going to hear a lot about that within the Career Center, within the College of Education, and indeed to our profession. Of course, she's been a very skilled and capable instructor and teacher for many years. You see on the tables all of the work that she has helped to author and co-author, journal articles, books. Last I checked, she has helped to develop the theoretical underpinnings of the FSU Career Center. She, of course, served as president of the National Career Development Association, so she can recognize that national and international level as a leader in our profession. Everything ranging from what faculty do, conduct research, teach, develop leadership opportunities in the profession. So Janet has really done it all. In terms of specific positions within the Career Center, I'm not going to chronicle all of these, but she served as associate director and program director for advising counseling and programming when that theory comes to life. She's currently an associate dean professor in educational psychology and learning systems, and she's program director for instruction, research, and evaluation. One other point I even forget, because when I left Florida State to return to my alma mater to direct Penn State's Career Center, Janet, faculty reliability factor, stepped in and served as interim director. That was 2011. So she's director of the office as well, in addition to serving on the faculty. I can't help but reminisce just a little bit. Janet, we first met in the old Bryan Hall. The career center is located in Bryan Hall. For our first men there, Coburn on the second level of Dean of Students. I'll never forget that balcony in the second level of Bryan Hall. I always thought it was going to catch fire. This is a scary place. Then we moved to the University Center. Of course, now we're in the world-class Dunlap Success Center. Back to the University Center, and Dr. Lenz's attention to detail. She always believed it was important for us to be open and be 20 in a week. To be more accessible to students and to serve community members. So historically, we've been open generally on Tuesday nights. So with great fanfare, I believe we were the first office to occupy the University Center when we moved there. We were on the fourth level, and we made coffee mugs with a rendering of the University Center. We had all kinds of ads saying, "We're now in the University Center, please visit us," and we're open Tuesday nights. Well, our first Tuesday night, we got all geared up, ready to go. And I looked around and dang, there are just no clients here. There are no students. I mean, what is the problem? The place was empty. And we're up in the fourth level walking around, and I looked down in the courtyard and saw a few students milling about down there. And I looked inside, no students anywhere. Well, what we learned was doors were locked on the first level. So we had to get that fixed pretty quick. Anyway, Janet, it's been a wonderful career. I'm really privileged to work with you for now for about 23 years probably. So well done. You'll hear from me a bit more. I would like to begin to introduce our other speakers who will chronicle Dr. Lenz's great work over the next year. First, I'd like to introduce Dr. Mary Coomer, our Vice President for Student Affairs. One quick note, I won't say much about any of the speakers, but Dr. Coomer is approaching retirement. She just recently had a celebration and will end on May 19th, which is for me. And I am retired. Dr. Coomer is approaching retirement, so I can now make one better comment about what I really think. Categorically, Mary, you are the best vice president, the best boss, and the best person I've ever worked for.
That's very kind. Well, Janet and I go back all 31 years. We were both housed in Bryan Hall at that point in time. I was actually physically on the third floor at the top of the balcony. And the reason you thought it was going to catch fire, Jeff, because it was stuffed with all of the paper that was the career center library. It was literally wall-to-wall paper. But if you had lit a match, you would have all glad that didn't happen. But moved to the University Center together. I am the orientation office and Janet continuing with what was once called CCIS, Curricular Career Information Services. And Bob actually taught me as a master's student, so I've got to keep those career information sources straight. I see another oldie but goodie up there, Bob Connors. You were on the third floor of Ryan Hall as well. But we knew back then that we had something very special, and Janet is certainly one of the reasons why it is special, and all of you are a testament to that as well. I didn't have all those different descriptors of Janet. All I could think of when I was thinking about talking about your career was the term all in. Mm-hmm. And I think Janet is all in everything she does, whether it's kayaking, traveling, vacationing, hiking, she's all in. If it's FSU Knowles, she is all in. And not just the sports that everybody goes to, like football and basketball, but a lot of women's sports and other activities, so it's not just the in things, but it's all in for the Knowles. If it is working with her colleagues in the tech center or the career center, she's all in. We need to write a new edition of a book, she's all in. We need to redo the curriculum for the career planning class, she's all in. If she is on duty in the advising center and a student walks in the door, she is all in. And on Tuesday, when I was walking across the other side of campus, she was all in her shorts, visor, and carrying a little dolly of materials and like what was a plastic bin. She moving out? And of course she was all in, because a graduate assistant or graduate student in the office was conducting the annual surveys, and she was heading to, of course, the most remote location of the advising of the survey with all of the material she needed in her bin. And I'm sure she came back with her full quota of responses. I could probably go on and on about being all in, but I think most importantly, besides being all in for her colleagues and the division and Florida State University, most importantly, she was always all in for the students. And so when I asked her to serve as interim director of the Career Center in the gap between Jeff and Myrna, she was all in for that, but really only for one reason, because the students needed you to do that. So thank you so much for a remarkable career and all the gifts that you shared with Florida State.
Well, it's really, in a way, just a mixed occasion here, sad and happy. Happy that Janet's going to go and have a lot of fun. Sad for us, because we have been so lucky in EPLS, our leadership nickname, to have Janet as a colleague and a friend and a great collaborator for so many years. Now, Janet, of course, was here before I came. I haven't been here 31 years. But I could tell pretty quickly when I started to get to know the faculty that I was going to like Janet a lot. Janet is not exactly a person who pulls punches. Janet, you know where Janet stands. And I like that, because that's the way I am. So, point one about Janet. And by the way, this is some remarks maybe is something that any colleagues in the room, you know, just keep in mind the things I'm saying, future academics, keep in mind, I'm speaking it as a department chair, these are the kinds of things department chairs like. So Janet, very straightforward, very friendly as well, not just straightforward and hey, I'm going to tell you what I think, but in a very positive way. Second, Janet is timely. Let me say that Brian Richards, who sends his regrets, he wished he could be here, but he's dealing with secure margin. Brian and I always know that the first list of graduate assistants to come in for any semester is Janet's list. Janet is on top of getting the assistantships for the Career Center lined up, ready to go, way ahead of time. So, bugging Janet for something, never need to do it. And that's another, it's a small thing, but it's not a small thing. What else? Of course, why is she doing that? It's because she's there for the students. Now, Janet has hardly ever asked me for a thing for herself. In the, I don't even know how long I've been in the department chair, but maybe it's like 8 years now or something. And in that time, Janet, I think, asked for something for your computer. And yes, of course the answer was yes. And then Janet asked me for things for the students. And I tried as much as I could to give her the things she asked for, because it was all to help the students. And I may have had to say no once, but I tried hard because I knew Janet had the best interests of the students in mind. And we know how much she has the students in mind, because when we think about the legacy lab of the fellowship in Janet's name, and when we think about the Career Center and all the opportunities that have come to our students, it's Janet who comes to mind. And the last thing I'll have to say is, you know, Janet is really a remarkable member of our department, because Janet is really not a member of our department. So, it's kind of hard for me to say goodbye to somebody who's not a member of the department, but the fact is that Janet has been a person who has done two jobs for the entire time that I have known her. And not only has she done two jobs, she's done two jobs incredibly well. You never have to ask Janet to do something. We don't have to ask her twice. In fact, I don't know what we're going to do about staffing graduation, because virtually every time we said, who can go to graduation, Janet says, I can go. So the rest of you, guess what, somebody needs to say. And we really will miss you. And I guess the final thing that I have to say is, Casey, watch out. Very, very big shoes. So we wish you the best. We hope you have great fun. Although I'm actually kind of suspicious, because I heard that Janet's not really retiring. She's just moving her office over to the Career Center. So I may come check on you sometimes if you're in a pushy space over there working with the team. But we wish you the best. Yeah.